In this video, I'm going to run through connecting and using VictronConnect for the iPhone connected to a MultiPlus. You'll need a few accessories. The VE.Bus Smart Dongle itself. This converts VE.Bus to Bluetooth so you can see your phone. This thing comes with a little modular connection here. So I've connected the battery positive and battery negative to my batteries, and I'm then able to plug it in. Push it in so it's secure. Once it's connected, you'll see the Bluetooth light is on and blinking. On and solid this time, but on. I'll then connect it to the back of the Multi, connected through the VE.Bus port using an RJ45 UTP cable. Connect it in here and connect it in here. Now the VE.Bus Smart Dongle is connected to the Multi, I can open up VictronConnect on my phone. The device will connect. If this is the first time connecting, you can see it appear on the list here. If this is the first time connecting, you'll need to enter a password. As I've already connected, it'll just go straight through. The default password is 6 zeros. 0000000. Now that we're inside the app, we get an overview screen. We can see the battery voltage and state of charge, the status of the AC input relay, the status of the AC output power. We can also adjust the AC input current limit using these buttons, or by adjusting the positive and minus button, or by typing an option in here. You can also head to the detailed screen section, which gives more details about the AC input, AC output, battery voltage and state of charge, and the temperature. Up in the settings cog, you can adjust the mode of the inverter by switching it to charger only mode, inverter only, or off. Once it's done, you get a green tick and you'll hear the relay inside click off. You can also adjust the AC input current limit from this screen. The three dots up the top will let you see the product info, including the firmware version and the device name. That's introduction to VictronConnect on the iPhone when connecting to a MultiPlus with a VE.Bus Smart Dongle.